Arctic Circle. So just starting our trip here in Iceland. Godafoss waterfall. Roll off gear working okay?
Yeah. Hvis man er ung, så er det godt at komme I gang med at cykle. Kom ud og se I verden.
Det kan godt blive lige I dag.
Efter min fødselsdag den 13. februar, så skal jeg helt ned til helt ned til Tyrkiet og cykle og helt ned til noget der hedder Kukistan og Tjikistan og alle de arabiske lande og lidt mere af de lande man kommer til på sommerferie og sådan noget, sådan nogle barnlande, hvor det bare
heading to Myvatn, Mitch Lake in English. Let's hope it's not too bad. So, main road's not the best place to bike, there's lots of cars, but it has to give us plenty of room. What do you think of this place here, Jamie?
Good.
What is it?
Det nogle ting, som kommer ned fra jorden af. Og det måske sådan cirka 1000 grader nedenunder.
200.
200 grader.
This is the first sight of Lake Myvatn. Like I said, lots of strange
volcanic activity with hot steam coming out of the earth. Arrived here on the campsite in Myvatn. It's quite a. So it's called Myvatn in English, well in Icelandic. Bit of a cloud of flies. Luckily they don't not stick stinging us.
We hope not.
Just had to get out the tent. It's 7 o'clock in the morning, so it's too hot. Who would have believed that? Feels like we're in Italy in the time. So now it's breakfast time here in the Icelandic heat wave. Thought we was going to be here in 10 degrees with all our rain clothes on, but something happened and we came on the hottest day in Iceland.
A nice fresh bread for breakfast.
Nice bread. First time for a week.
They come to see for a video and it was video was good. So guys, sådan her, det er min nye uge. Og sidste gang var det sådan her, og nu bliver det sådan her, og bagefter. Så bliver det sådan der, og bagefter så bliver det sådan der, og bagefter bliver det sådan der.
Lucky today, the sun is extremely bright and strong today for Iceland. I think it's the hottest day they've had ever. Just cycling here away from Lake Myvatn, Mitch Lake. There's lots of midges, but luckily they didn't sting us. Okay, now they're called Krafla. We're all loaded up with food and bike to Godafoss again, stay on the campsite then tomorrow morning. Head down the F26. Probably for about 6 or 7 days through the interior. All loaded up with food. Most of all our clothes yesterday. All ready to got about 30 kilometers to do today, not too far. This is Lake Myvatn on a nice summer's day with no wind.
Bike. Two hundred and forty-seven kilometers and a half, and we have plus 50 miles.
We'll be right back.
the F26 road that goes through the middle of Iceland, right between the two glaciers. We're going to take us six or seven days, I think, to get through. It's all gravel road. So we look at the view. So, there we go. On day two, we have 26. We just had a night camping all on our own out here. That was nice. Not very often you get a chance to camp somewhere so remote. And there we go. Landmannalauger area in the mountains. 8 kilometers away, and the landscape changes completely here. There's something completely different. This review, it's weird, isn't it? Like Lord of the Rings universe.
the last day, and the first day of the last week, starting now. We just spent a night in a private hotel where we could have burgers. That was nice. A nice breakfast. Today we got tailwind and tarmac roads, which is a relief for us and the bikes. Should be mainly downhill. Tarmac all the way today. The sky is nice and blue this morning. Nice view of the mountains there. So yeah, let's see what today's like. It'd be nice to be on tarmac instead of first day we biked in Iceland without having to struggle. And tailwind, pretty much downhill all the time. Hekla sprung, it was 17 years ago. On average it erupts every 10 years, so pretty much overdue. Let's see if we can get around before it erupts. Today?
Yes, yeah,
I dag. Indtil videre,
vi håber
ikke på
for meget, men
indtil videre
er det rigtig
dejligt.
Så
den er ved at cykle igen. Den største vulkan er derovre. Det er cool. The biggest vulkan,
det er herovre, der er. What's the name of it?
We've changed direction and going north up towards a little town called Fludir, and then after that is Geysir. Stopped on the way and had chips, always helps. And we're doing 71 kilometers today, that's our record so far in Iceland.
We have cycling 701 kilometers now.
Dude, what's happening there? It's a geyser.
Yeah.
Sorry. Oh, no. A little eruption going on. Oh, little geyser. No, it's finished now.
It stinks a little bit here. It
smells like sulfur.
Yeah. It's not good to breathe in it. It's really stinky. Mm-hmm. So every time you are here in Iceland, it's hot water and it's coming down on the ground. You need to do that and hold your. And so one time, it's a. It, and again, and not breathe too much, as it's really stinky.
Yeah.
So, we're on the second day of week 3. Cycling from a little town called Fludir, where there was a place called the Secret Lagoon. Never knew anything about that until we turned up at the campsite. That was a nice surprise. We're going to have a swim in the water, warm natural spring. That was nice. So there we are. Cruising. I know wind so far. Atlantic Ridge, or Mid-Atlantic Ridge in action, where the ground's been cut in two. So, now this is the last evening before we head towards Reykjavik, and they're in the Thingvellir camping site. Now we can see the Mid-Atlantic Ridge over there, where the Iceland is being cut into two pieces. Just had a nice dinner here with the on the bench.
And this is my Shirley, and we have biking the army with some 15. We have do 815 kilometers. Mm. I need my mathematic in my head.
Site of Reykjavik. Nearly made it all the way from north to south with the interior. About 20 kilometers away.
Sit down.
There. And we are back within sight of Reykjavik. Yep, we're going to have a cappuccino in a real restaurant. The final kilometre of our 3-week tour from Iceland. Now we're back in Reykjavik.
bit of a wash. It's cold and we're pretty.
Shut up and sit down.